Come one, come all to a beautiful show. It's gonna be awesome and some other stuff. Some other musical stuff.
You Ghostnuts, motherfucker.
Welcome back, everyone, to another edition of the Ghostnuts podcast, episode 57, coming at ya on a long weekend here in Australia.
Because we're celebrating some Spicy Minx's little birthday.
That's it. The Queen's birthday, when in fact her actual birthday is in April. But the other 2 days ago, it would have been Prince Philip's 100th birthday.
Did you see that cute little story that the gave the Queen a rose, the current Queen a rose?
Yeah.
Or some flower to commemorate what would have been his 100th birthday. So just a little reminder to the Queen that your husband's dead.
Yep, and as I say, every rose has its thorn.
And every thorn
apparently is Jewish.
Okay.
But so we'll get into it. So, as you know, today's episode, the royal family. I think it's good to talk about it.
Aware the people and let them know why we're celebrating this day, right?
Yep. And first of all, I'd like to say about the royal family, we're not going to get too much in detail about the fact that there are cold-blooded reptiles.
Allegedly.
But we'll leave that for another episode because that's a full episode on its own.
Mm-hmm.
But shout out to the reptilian overlord who allegedly, by David Icke, put down the info. And I think that's the feds calling to shut us down.
And I'm going to shut them up.
Yeah, anyway. So you know,
I'll just get into it, like a bit of foundation work before we build up this whole fucking
build back better.
Yes, as they say at the G20 summit.
Yeah.
So the British royal family, like, basically comprises of Queen Elizabeth II, who is the actual queen now, right? And her close relatives. There's no real strict legal or formal indication of who is or who is not a member. So many members can be people who just support the queen in undertaking her little public engagements.
Hmm.
And pursue of charitable work. And the royal family are basically regarded as a mascots of British culture.
Like, are they?
That's what they're seen as, right? But then you look at, like, you go back, how did the royal family start? You just can't, like, fucking claim.
I'm a king.
Yeah, you can't just be like, you're the king of Australia. It doesn't happen that way.
No.
So basically the current royal family stems from the House of Windsor, which originated in 1917 when King George V proclaimed the last name of the family to be Windsor.
Isn't that funny? You just, like, we don't have a surname, but we're just going to make up
the
a
house.
Name.
Yeah,
like, you know, it's a house. Like, it's named house after name. A house. Do you know why they do that? Because we'll get into it a bit later, but how can you have the leader of England that's not even British? They're all German.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at their name, their actual surnames, if you do, like, look into it, their research.
Bit of ancestry.com for, like, your bitch ass.
Mountbatten and, like, Coburg Sachs and Battenbergs, which is
a nice biscuit you could enjoy with your coffee.
Yeah, well, apparently it's a nice German biscuit.
A nice Bavarian brunch biscuit. Anyway, with that, yeah, basically they, through wars and claiming territories and all this shit, you get kings and stuff claiming to be the ruler, right? So I'm going to skip through the majority of it, but basically get the juicy parts. And when William the Conqueror became the King of England, his descendants ruled in the centuries that followed, right? After the death of Queen Elizabeth, the OG, the Virgin Queen.
Was she though?
She actually, who knows? Apparently never married, never bore children, never copped that dick.
You never know.
You never know unless
you've been there.
Yeah.
But anyway.
But I think, no, actually, I think they did perform little virginity test on her.
How?
Check if the hymen was broken.
True. But also, how can...
Unless she was fucking some little pin dick.
Yeah. The question I have is, how Queen Elizabeth's father was Henry VIII, right? Now, that guy had an insatiable appetite for lust, like he shares that with Elton John. But how could his daughter be so...
Lustless?
Lustless, if that's a right word to say it. But if her father, you know, you surely have some horny genetic, right?
That was passed down. Who knows, bro? Who knows?
Well, the mother
maybe she was horny for the country, for the kingdom.
Wasn't the mother Anne Boleyn?
I'm not sure.
And she was portrayed in a film by Natalie Portman.
One of the OG... I'm not going to say it because I might get myself in fire.
Undercover Mossad agents?
Allegedly.
We'll go with it.
So basically, yeah, after her death, you have the kingdoms of England and Scotland. They became united. So getting all these countries to get the United Kingdom, right? In 1801, Ireland was also included in the Union to form the United Kingdom. Then steps in, you got the complete opposite of this bitch. You get Queen Victoria coming in. Mm. And what does she do? She's just such a lush. She just fucks her first cousin, marries her first cousin.
And pop 9 kids or something.
Prince Albert, yeah. And this is where this inbreeding like caused these diseases called hemophilia. And these hemophilia riddled children spread through the European families. And what's hemophilia? Your body doesn't produce blood clots, so you can't stop yourself from bleeding.
Mm.
So say one day you got fucking just shitting on the toilet, for example, or a hole back in those days.
Mm.
You pop a hemi.
Yeah.
Your ass bleeds out.
Yeah.
Non-stop stream of blood. You die on the toilet from blood loss from shitting.
And then like a bit of intestine.
Well,
a bit of intestine comes out as well, and then the rats in that hole in the ground start climbing it.
Oh, well.
And start infesting your body with a rat plague, which is happening apparently in Campbelltown these days.
Okay.
But anyway.
So yeah, there we go. So fast forward from that shit, and you got King George V, who issues the royal proclamation of the House of Windsor.
Yeah.
And that's when you have like an official last name. And then blah, 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 jump, bada bing, bada boom. Fast forward, jump to 1952, where Queen Elizabeth II begins her reign.
Yeah.
Under the 1952.
Till today.
Yeah, she still runs the shit. So Elizabeth II is the Queen of the United Kingdom and Great Britain, Northern Ireland, whatever, head of the Commonwealth of all nations. So this encompasses like a shitload of countries, right? If you look at the land as well, it's like 20-something percent, 21% of North America she owns. Well, essentially, you know.
Well, yeah, it's all of Canada pretty much.
And a population of 2.4 billion people.
Yeah. And all the... if you think you were safe here in Australia, because we're just in a deserted island, and I said that because half the island's a desert. We're under her rule.
Yeah.
So this is sort of like how you said, how we mentioned a few weeks ago with the Vatican. Technically, if you're Catholic, the Holy See is...
You're part of that army.
Yeah, you're part of the Jesuit, you're a Jesuit soldier.
Yeah.
So this is like, because we're in the Commonwealth and they want to give us like benefits of saying, oh, we'll give you your own Olympic Games.
So you can get a couple gold medals, yeah, where you would fail.
That's,
you
know, it. But what's it called? Yeah, it's just like we're under the Commonwealth, we're under the Queen. So all of us are under the Queen. And I'm not talking about the instrumental remedy by Freddie Mercury.
Yep. Another guy who had an insatiable appetite that drove him to his death.
Yeah.
Okay.
Interesting fact when you talked about the Queen Victoria being marrying her first cousin. Just like with this inbreeding sort of stuff, not many people know that Queen Elizabeth II and Prince Philip were third cousins. So their great-grandmother...
They like the taste of their own fruit, eh?
Yeah. The great-grandmother on both sides is Queen Victoria. So that's a bit of a food for thought.
Food for thought.
So it's like we got the bloodlines. We want a purity. Let's... You know, have this Kabbalist bloodline of the elites, you know, one of those ones.
And keep it going, keep it in the family.
Mm.
So, right, we've said all this, but we also said the royal family is kind of like a mascot of the United Kingdom. But what power does that royal family have, right? You wouldn't think much, right? You think most of it's parliamentary,
yeah,
like goes through the parliament, which most of it does, right? But the Queen herself can basically pardon criminals if she sees fit. So she can grant a royal pardon to anyone convicted of a crime.
I think she did that for Prince Andrew.
Well,
we'll get to it.
Yeah. So the original purpose of the royal pardon was to provide exemption from the now abolished death penalty, apparently. So she can also command the armed forces.
So like...
Which is pretty crazy,
martial
right?
Law?
She's the commander-in-chief of the United Kingdom. Military force.
She can declare martial law.
If she wants.
And martial war.
Yes.
and Marshall Mathers.
Yeah, well, you gonna drop something?
She probably has.
Well, fucked him.
My lips are sealed.
Mom spaghetti. All British soldiers must swear an oath to her before officially joining the armed forces. So she has the power to command the army, though, which is kind of crazy. And she has also comes the she also has the power to delegate that as well. So the Queen can assign the position of Commander-in-Chief to another government official, most commonly the Prime Minister or the Secretary of State for Defence.
Who's that, Boris Johnson?
what's he going to declare war on? Fucking kale. That fucking marshmallow.
Bit of beer on the last drinks.
He looks like... I'm not going to get into what...
Say it.
It's like they just got a homeless man off the street and slapped a suit on him.
I was going to say, a hardcore... Third Division English Premier League fan.
Goalkeeper.
Yes. That's just sitting there. You want to be the fucking Prime Minister?
Okay. Have a go.
We'll give you a shot.
Yes. So with the Queen being able to command the army, that means she can declare war. The Queen, so who knows if your dog shits on her fucking lawn and your family lives in Zimbabwe, I don't know. Fucking oh, I went that way. Yeah. She'll fucking declare war on Zimbabwe.
Interesting.
She can also dissolve parliament if she sees fit. And it's like pretty extensive, right? Like, you wouldn't think the Queen would have that much real power. I don't know if she actually uses it though, but yeah, it's... Whip it out.
But there's something that's more powerful, allegedly, than her.
Well, what's that?
The Rothschilds.
Coming in hard.
Yeah. So these guys, as we've mentioned...
Let's just say this is a theory that is circulating, right?
There's a theory. All right, there is a theory and there is a non-theory. The non-theory is that the Jacob Rothschild, I believe, is the actual consultant for the royal family and controls the banking in London, as he did over the years. Because remember, as he once said, his great-grandfather once said, I don't care who is in charge of the country.
No, that's what
I'm in charge of the money,
yeah.
Which means I can control the people or some shit.
Like George Michael said, I don't need you to care. Mm. I don't need you to understand. You play that in the background? I don't know. Copyright.
Because he's talking to the Queen. Yeah. I'm your man.
Yeah.
So fucking Jacob Rothschild. And we'll get into George Michael a bit later on. He's canoodled.
That's a rope that swings...
Yeah,
both ways.
He did something. What? Yeah, he did. No, well, he did, and then it's just one way towards the end of his life. But so these Rothschilds. Let's get into it. Apparently, Queen Victoria's father is a Rothschild.
Can you please elaborate? That's just a massive statement you dropped there.
Okay. Well, he all right. There's some believable intel to balance the non-believable intel.
Okay.
So as we mentioned, like all these royal family people, they're like German.
Yep.
Rothschilds originated from Germany. Pretty much the Illuminati started in Germany under the Jesuit puppet, which was brought over from
Ignatius
Israel.
He's saying
Israel traveled through North Middle Europe, Kazakhstan era, found its way through travel to Germany under a false Israeli presence. They were asked, what is your nationality? And they just said, we're Jewish. However, they weren't Jewish. These Khazarians. But that's another whole episode on its own. Anyway, made the way to Germany. Germany is sort of like the central breeding ground of of inbreeding. Yep. And what's it called? This royal family shit. Okay. Rothschild's connection. Send my kids around the world like Daft Punk. And then what's it called?
Well, Beyonce had girls around the world.
Well, they weren't girls. They were boys. And the only girls those boys could marry were their cousins.
Mm.
So, yeah. So, long story short, connection, Rothschilds, Germany, England, royal family from back before this Queen Elizabeth stuff. So what happened? They wanted to create their own re-Christianized Jew world order, allegedly.
Rolls off the tongue nicely.
Yeah. So what happens? Nathan Rothschild has a son. His son is Lionel Rothschild. Lionel Rothschild allegedly went to Germany to marry Queen Victoria's mother, allegedly. They birth Queen Victoria. Then they have children, 9 children. Half of them copped a sleaze stack because of her blood condition.
Yeah.
One of them was called Lionel under her father's name.
All night long.
Dancing on the ceiling. And and that's the quick run title of this Rothschild shit. But it goes more deeper than that. Like, you've seen that infamous photo of one of the Rothschilds poking Prince Charles like it's his schoolyard bitch.
What are you implying?
That he's like, listen, he sausage fingers.
Yeah.
You do what I say or I'll fucking make your life a living hell.
Who knows? Could be. Because you got like royal insiders that are coming out and saying that basically the royal family is an insecure immigrant royal family who have never felt at ease with the British people, right? Mm. They don't see themselves as the same, right? More secure with immigrants and outsiders. Like you said, Rothschilds basically are, right? Because they spread across the land, trying to claim it all under their new world order, because that's the end goal.
Yep.
They want to fucking make a one world bank, a one world currency, one world government. And I'm not talking about the NWO from fucking WWE back when Hulk Hogan, let me tell you, brother, you know, fucking lifted Andre the Giant over his head at WrestleMania and fucking slammed him down. That's a new world order we fucking need, to be honest.
Yeah. But this family was the Saxe-Coburg. That was this.
Sounds very like fucking some. I want to suck on your Coburg. Grow on your body that just collects fluid.
Maybe it is. Also known as Henry Kissinger. Okay. So what we're trying to get is that without being anti-Semitic, there is a Jewish agenda.
We'll have it all in the show notes explaining it all. But basically, like, this Zionist Jewish thing runs through, like, maternal bloodline, right? So as long as your mother is Jewish, you are Jewish. And they... using that theory, well, statement that to run through the lines that Prince Harry,
Prince William are Jewish.
Prince William are Jewish because
dun, 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 dun.
Dirty Diana, sorry, Lady Diana, was in fact a Jew.
Yes, allegedly.
Allegedly, through her mother was Jewish. Apparently, she might have had an affair. Her mother might have had an affair.
Goldschmidt, have
a Goldschmidt running around.
Yeah.
So she bore the children of Prince Philip. Wait, no.
No, Prince Charles.
Prince Charles, sorry.
Yeah.
And they are now Jewish through their maternal bloodline.
Yes. But the funny thing is, you pointed out that Princess Diana had a Goldsmith surname, and so did Kate Middleton. So can one assume that there's also inbreeding in that family as well?
Well, there's a theory going around that Kate Middleton is actually a Jew as well. So she's from a maternal line of non-practicing, assimilated, and poor Sephardic Jews.
That's a mouthful.
Aligned to the Church of England. Mm. And she probably...
had a mouthful of...
She knows what to do with a mouthful.
Yep.
Her mother, whose maiden name is Goldsmith, as you said, practicing or not is Jewish under the Jewish law of maternal bloodline. Therefore, you know, as we said, Prince William will be legally Jewish, especially as William under Judaic law is also a Jew from his mother.
Yes, because his mother... is Jewish.
Yeah,
we said.
What goes around comes around, and what comes around is George Michael's big dick, apparently. Okay. So there was rumors circulating that George Michael was swinging that fucking rope
around Princess Diana.
Well, she wanted a piece of it. But this was back in the Club Tropicana days where it was kind of sus. No, it was probably after.
Yeah.
But it was kind of sus, right? Like, he was talking about... all his songs are about sex, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Outside. I think I'm done with the sofa. Like, he wants to fuck outside.
Yeah.
What else? Careless Whisper, cheating on someone.
Who was cheating on who, though?
I'm never going to dance
hint,
again.
Hint?
Yes.
Even Too Funky was about Prince Charles, I believe.
What?
Oh, yeah, some people don't really know this, allegedly, but you know the part where he says, I see your fingers working over time.
We've got to remind people. You got to put a photo up of his finger so you can remind people.
So yeah,
Prince Charles has some fucking Frankfurts growing out of his palms.
Those fingers working overtime. And I see you drinking that red wine, which is adrenochrome.
Yeah. Okay. So we're going to try to stick to the topic of this whole Jewish Zionist proclamation of ruling the world. And the original and current Jewish definition of a born Jew is a person whose mother is Jewish, as we know. And people have also always mystified why Charles married Diana, we know, to bore Jewish children. And then you go, blah, 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 coming of the Messiah. This is where shit gets interesting. The Talmud states that the leader of the world Jewish takeover would be a king, right? Meaning that should a male Jew ascend to the throne, such as a king, then himself not only be the elder, senior elder Zion, but also the long-awaited Messiah, the king of Jews, right? So they're basically holding on to the claim that Prince William, who's going to become king eventually,
yep,
he is a Jew.
And he's going to be the Antichrist?
Or his son, allegedly, or some
shit. Or his son's going to be the Antichrist, because apparently this comes from, if you look at old religious revelations, apocalyptic theories, the tribe of Dan is the evil tribe, and apparently they're the tribe that went to England, or they went up to the north section, so could be a link. Also, he's a member of the Order of the Garter, not the Order of the
Malta?
Carter.
Oh, Carter.
But what's it called? Yeah, so apparently there are theories that this Prince William could be, or even his son Prince George, could be the Antichrist.
Yeah, because it's weird, because you look at the old Masonic claim, right, and he states that Jerusalem will be rebuilt here in England's green and pleasant land.
Mm. Is it really green?
On a good day.
Anyway, as we mentioned, the technical name of London, City of London Corporation.
Yeah, so what does that entail?
So this is like we have the Vatican, we mentioned Washington, D.C., and London are its only, its own city-state buzziness, one-man torso alliance that apparently...
It's like its own separate entity from the country.
So from what's it called, the rest of England. So apparently, these Londoners back in the day were had different laws to other people in England. So they got benefits, which is pretty funny because... why would you, you know, be separated if you're not trying to grab control? You must have some benefit. Apparently, they had their own, that this two separate, this whole separate section in London was just like its own country. Like the Vatican, how you talked about how,
yeah,
that, you know, they've got their bank, they've got whatever, their own type of shit there.
They got their own pedophiles.
Yeah. So, in the UK Parliament, there's a has a representative and a person known as the Remembrancer. Sounds very
that's a
strange
a worst name I've ever heard.
Yeah. Who is present to protect the city, so they rely on this guy. Which is pretty fucked up.
That's probably the easiest job you gotta do. What do? You just sit there doing nothing.
Yeah. But you're like you must be a 33-degree Mason.
Is that confirmed or alleged?
Confirmed.
Okay.
In an alleged way. Another confirmed in a non-alleged way is the Prince Philip movement.
The fuck is this?
All right, so there's a island called Tanna.
What the fuck was that?
And Prince Philip movement is an actual like religious a cult, maybe a following in this island.
Look, this is a primitive island. Well, yeah. Primitive in the sense that the people there have not progressed in terms of technology. They still live in
huts.
And we're not talking about Pizza Hut with an all-you-can-eat fucking feast.
No. Yeah, so they believe that there's this a divine entity coming in as a human form. And on these old images they had, they looked very similar to Prince Philip.
Yeah.
So they just said, oh, he's God.
They've made Prince Philip into a god.
Yeah.
Some sad shit going on here.
It's pretty sad because they celebrate his birthday every year and they chuck a massive party just for him to hopefully
come back, but come he, back never, and he never comes.
And he never comes back because there was that time he visited in 1974, the only time he visited.
Imagine that. You throw a party for someone every year and they never show up.
Yeah. So they do things like, you know, they make kava tea. They do these dances, fire dances, annual feast of taro and pork, I believe it is.
Sounds good.
And, you know, they cook it underground.
Yeah.
Yeah. And what's it called? And they believe that he is the most powerful and that he's God. He's because by marrying the queen, because she's the most powerful woman in the world, it seems like he did the most powerful task.
Yeah, because they believe he's from that land, right? Yeah.
And they also believe that he's responsible for many world events.
Such as?
Apparently, he used his magic.
Okay, I can see him looking like a warlock, yeah.
And he ensured that America had a safe election after Barack Obama became president.
Okay. So what they're saying is he rigged the election.
apparently.
So yeah, I wonder how they'll take the news of him dying. But then again, they believe when his mortal body dies, his spirit will return back to the land.
Anyway, quickly before I run Tartar out of town, Prince Philip, the famous quote, when I die, I want to come back as a virus. What do you reckon?
What?
Yeah, because there's too much overpopulation.
Did he say that?
He actually said that. So what do you reckon? New strain?
What do they call it? The Prince Philip strain?
Probably.
What happens? Your fingers blow up?
I don't know. Maybe for his son, which are...
We'll
talk about the other son now.
Prince Andrew and Jelaine, right? Look, we've discussed this multiple times, so I'm just going to quickly run through it, just a bit of a refresher. Yeah. So you know what type of scumbaggery goes on in this royal family.
Yeah.
So we should all be aware of what he's done, right? Fucking watch your previous episodes if you haven't. About the... We had the gimp on. He was fucking locked away by Prince Andrew. So... But you got Prince Andrew saying, well, the thing is, it's funny how this story has died, right? And we can attribute this to this whole Meghan Markle and fucking bullshit that she's half black and it's racism running through the royal family, right? They're just using this as a fucking smokescreen to sweep this shit under the rug and to make you forget about Prince Andrew. So I'm just going to, look, I got all these show notes here. You can read them if you want a refresher. What did Prince Andrew do? He fucking lied, said he didn't know Epstein. Bullshit, there's multiple accounts of him visiting Epstein. Jumped on a jet multiple times, it's in the flight logs. Fucked a couple of his prepubescent fucking
kids.
Victims, right? Claims that he doesn't know him and never happened. You got eyewitnesses that saw him at a club with those victims. There's a photo of him with fucking his fucking good mate, Virginia Roberts Giuffre, who he allegedly had sex with three times on three occasions. And he's got... That photo's photoshopped. Mate, I can see your fucking sausage fingers with a vice-like grip on a hip.
We can see that sweat pouring out of that shirt.
So, look, I'm going to break it down. He's friends with Ghislaine Maxwell. There was speculation and rumors that they were dating because they've seen at multiple public events together at like Heidi Klum's or some shit, Pimps and Hoes birthday party.
Really?
Yes. There was some bullshit party. He was there with her. He flew him, like they came over for his daughter's birthday.
Yeah.
They've, you know, he's obviously been with Epstein multiple occasions. We know that. Apparently they weren't close. Bullshit, mate. You've been to his house multiple times. He had sex with, apparently he was in a haram on in the island with a bunch of women.
And also with Paul Keating's daughter.
Well, that was Epstein. Who knows? She was probably there as well, that fucking horse. So what now for Prince Andrew, right? So he stepped down from official duties, right? He's trying to fucking step down from the limelight. Five Epstein accusers want him to give evidence in US courts, saying he must talk to the FBI. Their lawyer, David Bowles, and I'm not talking about the fucking bowls you smoke out of.
Or not those bowls between your legs.
Yeah, the ones that don't sweat apparently. He claims that Andrew witnessed men being given massages at the Epstein Mansion, right? And pre-trial witnesses subpoenas have been prepared for the five cases and could be served on the prince if he sets foot in the US again. So we know he's not going to go back to the US, right? He's hiding low. And then you got this whole Harry and Meghan. Hagen. I just made a fucking unison coming out saying all this bullshit. Now that's taking the fucking limelight of Prince Andrew.
That whole Oprah fucking meeting that they had, whatever.
Yeah, and they're saying this bullshit that the royal family's racist. That's why they killed fucking Princess Diana, because she was going to bear a bastard Arab son.
Mm. Anyway, like the thing that I...
Yeah, sorry, I'm just fucking veered off track there.
No, but it's true, because it's like veering away. But the funny when you say that about, what's it called? What's her name? Meghan Markle and stuff. Apparently, she falls under a... elite bloodline as well.
Here we go. Yeah.
So this is why she got selected to marry Prince Harry. Marry Prince Harry, one of those ones. The DuPont bloodline apparently is another German...
Is it worthy enough?
Illuminati.
Yes, sir.
Kabbalist blood type. So apparently because her dad is white and he actually drips down from that DuPont bloodline... Apparently, they're like, yeah, true, because she actually had to take a blood test before she got engaged.
What, the Queen made her take a blood test?
Apparently.
To see she was worthy.
But the thing is, I don't know if it was a blood test in regards to, what's it called?
A blood sacrifice?
No, just to actually do a test of the bloodline to see where the bloodline comes from. Or if it was just a blood test to shove it in fucking rotting... Prince Philip's
one of those blood infusions,
so you can get a bit of extra life, if you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, because that I was going to say something bad, but that bloke, when you're that age and you get admitted to hospital, you're basically going to the funeral home. Yeah. Let's be honest here. You're not coming out there alive. And he made so many trips back and forth. Like, you're wondering, what the fuck are they giving him there? Give him some young blood transfusions. Yeah. Who fucking knows? Give him another week to live.
Yeah, but what's it called?
And speaking of racism in the royal family,
here we go.
There's a little fucking story of kidnapping Indigenous children in Canada. Those were no Canada's part of the Commonwealth, yeah. Right? And like, have you heard of this shit?
Yes.
So it's a fucked up story. And apparently, Queen Elizabeth was issued an arrest warrant in 2013 from the Common Law Court of Justice in Brussels. And this isn't a laughing matter, because there was apparently a litigation on Queen Elizabeth and her husband, Prince Philip. They were found guilty in the disappearance of 10 native children from the Catholic-run Kamloops Residence School in British Columbia. So, apparently grieving parents haven't seen their children since.
Mm.
They went on a royal picnic with them in 1964. And what happens? You got eyewitnesses. This one bloke, William Combs, and he was 59 at the time, in good health. He was scheduled to be a primary witness at the opening session of the International Tribunal, right? What happens? He was told to go get a checkup at some weird hospital he has never gone to. He goes in, right, at St. Paul's Hospital, and William then has to go for tests, right? He goes for the test. He becomes ill and immediately starts to deteriorate and then suddenly dies before he gets to stand trial.
Interesting.
And what was he saying, right? You want to go through the testimony quickly before he died?
I'll quickly run through it. I am an interior Salish spirit dancer and I am 58 years old.
So you know he's on that shit, bro.
Yeah.
So basically you got some crazy fucking
DMT on that ayahuasca native frying cactus leaves.
It could be because he witnessed an atrocity.
Maybe. Yeah. I live in Vancouver, Canada. I am a survivor of the Kamloops.
Sounds like some rip-off you find at Aldi or Fruit Loops.
I was going to say like the opposite of an Oompa Loompa.
Mm.
A Kalumpa.
Okay.
And Mission Indian Residential School, both are run by the Roman Catholic Church. I suffered terrible tortures. There are at the hands especially of Brother Murphy, who killed at least two children.
That's a big statement.
Mm. At least, anyway. I witnessed them throw a child off a tree. Sorry, not a tree, a three-story building. That's even worse, isn't it?
I don't know, bro. Three stories enough to kill you? But if you're a child, I guess, so you land on your head.
True. He put me on a rack and broke some of my bones in the Kamloops school basement after I tried running away. I also saw him and another priest burying a child in the school orchard one night.
There's stories coming out that they found like a bunch load at this school of buried bodies, like they had no idea, like 200 something buried bodies.
Now this is where it gets interesting. In October 1964, when I was 12 years old, I was an inmate at the Kamloops school and we were visited by the Queen of England and Prince Philip. I remembered it was strange because they came by themselves, no big fanfare or nothing. But I recognized them at the school principal, and the school principal told us that it was the queen, and we got given new clothes and good food, and the first time in months, the day before she arrived.
So they wined and dined them well before the queen. Get on your best behavior. Can't look like you're not a shit kicker, because the fucking big chops are coming in.
Mm. The day the queen got to the school, I was part of a group of kids that went on a picnic with her and her husband and some of the priests down to the meadow near Dead Man's Creek. That's a, you know,
ominous sign.
It should be a sign right there. But anyway, I remember it was weird because we all had to bend down and kiss her foot with a white laced boot.
And if some kids there had a foot fetish, that would set them ablaze. You know what I'm saying? Maybe they use that as a test.
Maybe. Maybe Quentin Tarantino was a kid there. Anyway, after a while, I saw the queen leave the picnic and with 10 children from the school, and those kids never returned. We never heard anything more about them and never met them ever again when they were older. So they were all from around there and they all vanished.
Okay, so basically, to sum it up, Queen came in, made some kids kiss her foot, and she went to like a indigenous school, but I'm guessing because she probably thought they were from poor families or whatever, probably could take some without giving some, in the sense of she'll off the children, her and Prince Philip, and no one would notice, sort of thing, or no one would say anything. And that's what apparently happened.
But that's very interesting. So, and one more little just nugget.
A little footnote just to put a stamp on this episode.
Yeah.
I think you've all heard of Jack the Ripper, right?
Yeah.
Well, you might want to look into Prince Albert Victor, because he was assumed to be Jack the Ripper, this motherfucker.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
that's about it, mate. So, pretty interesting. It's on the show notes, but I just wanted to do a quick summary. So we have German inbreeding descent family that have their own City of London corporation that is controlling all of the United Kingdom.
They can use the United Kingdom as an army to declare war.
Then German, and Jewish background with the Rothschild connections.
Yeah.
With that, the whole Princess Diana,
fucking George Michael allegedly,
apparently, and this
bastard child, racism,
Arab guy,
Jewish bloodline.
Yeah, so they wanted
the Prince William and Harry.
And what's the quote? They got the Jewish thing. So, what has 10 dicks and a vagina?
Lady Gaga.
I was gonna say Prince Charles, because those fingers are like mini penises, and I'm not talking about the ones that Nicole Kidman would like to join in that
haram. Allegedly.
What's it called? So, and also good mates with Klaus Schwab.
Ah, yes.
Very good mates.
I forgot to mention that, yeah.
How did he get like, you know, let's just...
They're pushing for the global reset.
Yeah, well, that's pretty much that in a nutshell. If you want to refer back to episode 36, Klaus Schwab and Prince Charles' little orgy. And speaking of orgy, we have Ghislaine Maxwell, Prince Andrew, and Jeffrey Epstein with a bunch of underage kids. And speaking of underage kids in a non-sexual way, or maybe it is, the kidnapping of some Canadian natives.
Mm, making them kiss her feet.
Yeah. So it's just there's some fucked up shit about the royal family that is just out there. Believe it if you want. Believe if you not. But... the big chungus one is the fact that they're reptilians.
That's a big statement. That will get us banned off most media platforms.
Yeah.
Allegedly. People say.
If there are any anyone out there that is a sort of...
expert in the field?
Yeah, in the reptilian. Maybe you've met some reptilians in your times.
Reach out to us. We'd love to hear from
you. Yeah, we'd love to hear your side of the story. Send us an email.
Ghostnutspodcast@gmail.com. Yep. Or you can contact us through our website.
Ghostnutspodcast.com. Hit us up. All our show notes are here, as crazy as they sound. And this has been a bit of a fudgery of an episode because it's all over the shop. Just you can read the show notes and they're there. It's fucked up what you can find sometimes at the depths of the night just researching into that fucking satanic AI box that we call a computer.
Isn't that fucked up? Like, how the fuck can this, say, a laptop connect wirelessly to this fucking information network? Well, what the fuck is going on here? Who created... Anyway, I'm not going to go into a tangent.
5G, baby.
I don't want to get on this convo. But yeah, I guess enjoy your fucking extra day off.
Well, that's only for people in Australia.
In the Commonwealth, not in Australia, whatever. Fuck it. I guess. See you later, boys.
Ghostnuts, motherfucker.
Ghostnuts. Podcast, boys.
Are they discussing this on the Ghostnuts podcast? Are you? You guys need to break this fucking down.
This is a chopper!
Kill your fucking selves, you fucking globalists!
We can't see them. They can't see us.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
God, I love those Ghostnuts.